It has been a long and difficult journey to get to or closer to witnessing the very first and historic launch of the enormous Starship rocket. SpaceX's giant Starship Mars rocket could attempt to go orbital for the first time as soon as next week. For months now, SpaceX has been gearing up for the first ever Starship orbital test flight, which will be carried out by the Super Heavy prototype Booster 7 in a Starship vehicle called Ship 24. In mid-March, SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk said that the landmark flight from SpaceX's Starbase facility in South Texas might launch as soon as the third week of April. But recent developments suggest that the attempt could come even sooner than that. For example, SpaceX rolled Ship 24 out to Starbase's orbital launch pad over the weekend, multiple Starship watchers have observed. Overnight, Ship 24 was rolled into the arms of the old chopsticks. Are we going to see a S-24 lift? Or is it possible we see a cryo? We've seen a ship cryoed right next to the Ulm before. And on Monday, April 3, the company conducted fueling tests with Booster 7 on the orbital launch mount, with Ship 24 on the ground nearby. SpaceX is ready to stack Starship 24 atop of Booster 7, I think it might happen today. Before orbital launch, SpaceX might testing cryo test with full-stacked Starship. While a launch is not imminent this week, it could take place as early as April 10, sources said. On April 1, Elon Musk tweeted and said, "The Starship first orbital launch is more than days away, but hopefully not many weeks away." A few days earlier, marine notices for SpaceX Starship orbital flight test have been published. Possible launch date of SpaceX Starship first orbital launch debut is take place on between the 10th of April to the 12th of April according to notice issued by Marine. In addition, navigational warnings have been issued for the Starship orbital attempt, as Netherlands-based satellite tracker Marco Langbroek noted. Those warnings cover a window of April 6 to April 12. It doesn't appear that SpaceX will try to hit the first part of that proposed window. For starters, the company is still waiting for a launch license from the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, as Musk said last month. SpaceX has scheduled some notice to mariners. We've seen them schedule notice to mariners before. This is basically SpaceX telling boating captains and people with boats to stay away from potentially exploding rockets. It's a very typical thing for the Cape, and they've done it a few times here in Starbase, for all the suborbital flights, and a lot of the static fires and large pressure tests that they've done, like the full wet dress rehearsal. What makes these mariners' notices unique? It's for Hawaii, which means we're that much closer to SpaceX hopefully being able to fly the full-stack Starship. But don't get too excited, because these aren't full launch licenses. We're still waiting on the official FAA approval for SpaceX to launch the full-stack Super Heavy. These notice to mariners are scheduled for April 6 through April 12, which is a 6-day window every day between 1255 UTC. But April 10 or April 11 look like real possibilities, according to Ars Technica's Eric Berger. The CEO of SpaceX can better speak to this. Elon Musk's Starship is a brand new rocket that has yet to be seen in the entire space industry. It is said to be the successor to SpaceX's very successful rocket, the Falcon 9. This massive rocket is expected to outperform the Falcon series of rockets by taking on a variety of missions, including one that is highly anticipated by space enthusiasts, to land humans on the surface of the moon once more. It is for this reason that NASA has been closely monitoring the progress of the Starship since its inception, and it is for this reason that the Federal Aviation Administration is not willing to take anything to chance. In fact, SpaceX and the space regulatory agencies have frequently crossed paths, and the ambitious private space company has found itself on the wrong side of the agency laws several times. One such drama occurred back in 2020, when SpaceX was conducting a high-altitude Starship prototype test. Suffice it to say, it ended up noisy and messy, and the noise of its loud explosives contributed to this. The landing appears to have piqued the interest of FAA officials, who were well aware that SpaceX had violated the agency's regulations. Nonetheless, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk and his staff celebrated with shouts of excitement, declaring that the test was a success. But of all the unruly endeavors of SpaceX, the most recent one cost Elon Musk both time and money. In August 2022, SpaceX launched its Starlink satellites to orbit as they have usually done. However, they failed to provide the Federal Aviation Administration with proper data, about the launch and its potential for collision with debris in orbit. According to the Federal Aviation Administration, SpaceX was required to submit the data to the agency at least 7 days prior to the attempted launch. SpaceX was fined $175,000. SpaceX requires a launch license from the FAA before launching Starship into orbit from Starbase, and the fate of SpaceX's Boca Chica facility has been in doubt for nearly 2 years. While the FAA conducts an environmental review of how the company's launch operations will impact the surrounding area. Initially, SpaceX had no plans to launch its future Moon and Mars rocket from Texas. Indeed, the company's first piece of land in Boca Chica, purchased in 2012, was intended to be a commercial launch site for its smaller Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, with the goal of launching up to 12 times per year from this serene location. The FAA completed a thorough environmental study of the proposed launch site in 2014. To make sure that SpaceX's plans complied with environmental rules, and were away from the hustle and bustle of its much busier launch facilities in Cape Canaveral, Florida. Despite the original plan, the agency published an environmental impact statement that detailed how the smaller launches would affect the area. SpaceX eventually decided to launch its future Moon and Mars rockets from Boca Chica. After realizing that the site's remote location and proximity to the Gulf of Mexico made it an ideal location for testing and launching Starship spacecraft, which can take many months, if not years, to complete. As it necessitates interviews with experts, scientists, business officials, and residents, as well as rigorous analysis and research into how a proposed action will affect the nearby human environment. However, SpaceX's plans have shifted significantly since the original was published. Beginning in 2018, the company significantly increased production activities in Boca Chica, after deciding to devote the South Texas facility solely to the production of Starship prototypes. The more modest commercial launch facility that SpaceX once envisioned has evolved into a thriving installation, filled with massive warehouses, intense construction, and thousands of employees working around the clock. As SpaceX's presence in the area grew, the company began conducting high-altitude flight tests with its Starship prototypes, launching the vehicles up to heights of 30 to 40,000 feet, before attempting to land them back on Earth. The majority of these tests ended in fiery explosions, with only one successfully sticking its tongue out. One prototype blew up just before it was supposed to land in March of 2021. The test flights, combined with ongoing construction and ground testing, have led to growing tensions with the nearby community. The Starbase is located next to a small neighborhood of a couple dozen homes called Boca Chica Village, which is only really accessible via one lone state highway that connects the Starbase.